Hello, very good morning. This is Abhay from Manu Patra Informations. Thank you for joining me for the day two of the session we are doing for students. I hope you are at home, safe with your family at this difficult time. Let's use this time to make the most of it by brushing up on our legal research skills. Let me start with a brief intro of my company. So Manu Patra Information Solutions started with 2020 with the pioneers of online legal search in India. Since then, we have grown into the largest content aggregator for national and international database, linking both primary and secondary database. We have offices in 22 cities across India. So what has helped us stay relevant in our field is we see ourselves as a technology company. So not just as a database provider, but a hardcore technology company, which provide tools like artificial intelligence, natural language processing, analytics, editorial inputs at right places, so that our users can get to the best result in the least possible time. So a lot of thought goes in Manu Patra to enable our users to see a pattern in the sea of data that is available outside. Okay, with that, let's begin with a demo. This is, you can just put in your username or password here. If your college has an IP subscription, so the minute you are connected with the college Wi-Fi, there is an option available here for IP access. You can click on to that one and you will be able to get into the portal. Okay, so one more thing, just before starting the session, yesterday we were taking all the questions at the end of the session. So today what we have decided by the feedback is that after each features or like list of features that we have used, we'll be asking you questions. So I'll take two questions after each feature. At the end, if you have time, we'll take more questions. Okay. That is that. Yesterday, we took a deep dive into the table of contents. So everything we had covered, what we are covering in the table of contents, and I showed you one judgment using Manu Search. Today, we'll be focusing on all these three, four searches: Manu Search, Legal Search, Citation Search, Assisted Search. Okay, let's begin with Manu Search. Manu Search, as I told you yesterday, this is the heart of Manu Patra. So we go to clients and they have been using it for 20 years. So this is their favorite search. The benefit is that you can just type what's coming to your mind. So many people, like even old users till today, just type, say, and it will fetch you results. Okay, so automatically it will take code of criminal. So this is because this is very helpful. People depend on Manu Search, but there are different searches also. Legal search is there, assisted search is there. So today the point is that you will be able to use better these searches. So, you know, you take you to the advanced level. Not a lot of people might be using this, but just small features that will help you immensely doing your research. Okay, so let's start with Manu Search again. I'll put in a simple query, say appointment arbitrator. This is our pet query. So appointment of arbitrator, it's taken these three words and in whichever judgments they are there, 19,000 some judgments, within half a second you'll be able to see all these judgments. Okay, so now starting from here only, so if you have a confusion on a particular query, so there is a option available where you can see the meaning of that particular word. So legal meaning is available for your query search terms. Now, another option is there, people who have searched for appointment of arbitrator also. So this is crowdsourcing. So people who have done historically, they've searched for appointment of arbitrator in Manu Patra. What is their step two? So this is, we are giving you that trend. So they have refined their search with foreign award. So you can click onto this. Now you'll see the number has come down to 2,525 judgments, where appointment of arbitrator is there and similarly foreign award is also there. You can always search in result mode. Say if you want to search for natural justice. Okay, so you can refine it further. So many times what people do is they write 2-3 sentences on the first Go and Manu search. This is that comes intuitively because we have been trained in Google, and Google just has one search bar. There's no search in results. But Manupatra has that. You know, you can just start with your broader key terms and you can slowly come down to the accurate results. So this is how you do it. Just search in result, and n number of times you can do this from here. Now coming on to the filters, there are different filters available. So these filters are basically designed to help you narrow down on your judgment. So this is like, this is a graph which shows you over the years, the judgments on appointment of arbitrator has been rising. So 218, the up. Filtration is possible. So if you're just looking for a Supreme Court judgment, I want to see 54 Supreme Court judgments first that I can see. Keywords is if you're looking for, if you don't know what to do next, you know, again, suggestions for you. So there are authority, 48 bank guarantee, 64 judgments. So 64 judgments in the present list as bank guarantee in that. Judge wise, so if you have a particular judge sahab in mind, say E.K. Ganguly sir gave a decision on appointment of arbitrator, that is the one you're looking for. So you can always select judge sahab also from here. Period wise, so if you're looking for new decision 2010 and above, if you have a particular year in mind, so all these filtrations are designed so that you don't have to manually put that in Manu search. You can just come down here and see, like articles, 73 articles are available. Industry wise, so I am just looking for bank cases. So this is bank, 10 cases are available. Publisher wise, judgment wise, so I'm looking for decisions where 5 or more judges were there, constitutional bench. So first I want to look at those judgments. So you can always select this. 58 judgments where 5 more judges were there. So this was filtration and the nesting that we can do in Manupatra. So this is just the part one. So this is how do you use Manu search and how to use filters. So if there are any questions on this, I can take that 2 questions. And if not, I'll move to the second one. Okay. I guess I'm audible to most of the people because we have an IT team. Okay, good morning. The mail will be ticking. Okay, so if you want to see the newest decisions, it won't be taking the relevant one first. So from here, if you select like from 2010 and above, it will take the relevant ones. If you select from here, sorting is done from here, newest decision. So that won't be the most relevant one. But if you do from here, it will take the relevant one first. So it's okay. Refine in search. Article search will come to that again. Refine search, sir, I'll come to that again. In different search queries, we have planned different case studies for you. So I'll show you search and result again. Basically, you just type your query from here. Appointment of arbitrator, I can cancel this. So I can go back to appointment of arbitrator. Say, just write appointment of arbitrator and search. Okay. So these are my 9,000 some results. Now I can search and result from there. This radio button is available. Search and result, refine your search. So now if I select this search and result, there's a new option available. Say I say compensation. And I'll take. And now it has refined whichever judgment is appointment of arbitrator and compensation together. So these are 4,000 some results. So this was for refined search. Now let's come to the next topic that we are covering. Let's go back to the search history. So if you want to go back to the search history, you can do it from here and you can go to the previous search that you made. So natural justice. So our query is, how do you find out a particular case is overruled or not, or SLP is pending on that one? So this is a very common query that we have received from the students. There is a red flag that is there in front of a judgment which is overruled. So here there is no red flag, but here there is a red flag that denotes that this particular judgment, second one, has been overruled by some other judgment. Now, the second question that automatically pops in my head is, where is it overruled? Once you click on to this one, it will take you a judgment where it has been overruled. So this was overruled by 6 bench decision on SBP. Okay, so if it is overruled or not, then you will, if it is overruled, there is a flag. If it's not overruled, there is no flag. It might be dissented somewhere, but it is not overruled. The second part of the query was the SLP. So SLP, again, this is where you open the judgment in a new window. So these icons are available here so that you can see without a miss. So this is SLP has been disposed of in this case. Okay. So if there was a red one here, this would mean that SLP is still pending. So in the Calcutta High Court judgment, this has been disposed of. If you want to see which was this decision which in the Supreme Court, that can be checked from here. So I guess most of you understand what the SLP is. SLP is basically when a judgment is challenged in Supreme Court. So if it's disposed of, there's no problem. If it's still pending, then you need to little worry. This is for SLP good law, whether it has been challenged or whether it's still pending. Okay, let's take 2 more questions. Yes, sir. Abhinav, sir, this works for appeal pending. SLP Ganesh, sir, means that this particular judgment, a high court judgment, was challenged in Supreme Court. So sometimes that SLP is pending on that particular case, sometimes it's not pending. So it has been disposed of. So if it was challenged by Supreme Court, there would have been, there is a SLP status on that one. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, so this is Boolean search in Manu Patra. How to use near each other white cards. So this was one of the most requested in our feedback yesterday. So we are taking this today. In Manu search, there is an option for Boolean search. If you want to use Boolean search, you can use it. There is an option available in assisted search that is Boolean made easy. So here you don't have to even use Boolean search. There's a just fixed format that is given to you and you don't need to do much. But let's do it from Manu search only. And if you want to use Boolean, say I have a particular case dealing with child custody. So I'll just zoom in a little. So in whichever judgment, child custody is coming as a phrase. You know, I'm very sure that this particular judgment should have child custody in a phrase form. So it will take all those judgments where child custody is. Now from here, as we have learned, we can always do a search and result. Now I can refine this search. Say I'm looking for visiting rights. Okay. I'll just zoom in a little. Visiting rights. Now from here, visiting rights can be one thing, but there can be visitation rights. There can be visited by. So what I can also do here is what we called white cards. White cards is that visit, you can put a star after visit and rights. So it will take all the forms of visit. So it will be visited, and I'll be refined from that. Okay. So this is wild cards, and there you will be able to see, let me show you in one judgment. Visitation rights also it will take. Just let me go back. Come back here. VISIT rights. Okay. So now it's taking visiting also, visitation also. So all the forms of visit is also taken care of by just putting a star out of anywhere. So if you are writing kill here, you can put a, after kill you can write a star and it will take killed, and all those forms are also taken care of in that. Okay, let's search in result mode. Say you can always search in result. Say in this case no maintenance was paid, so I can just write no maintenance paid. So I guess you are understanding from here, you know, you'll be able to search in results. So the more you search in result, the better your results will be. Let's go to the next one. So this is one query that I took up from another webinar that we had a couple of days ago. So there was this government employee, okay, who was suspended from his job. So the query was he entitled for a salary or an allowance? Okay. So I'll just write my keywords there. So I've opened Manu Search, government employee, suspended from his job, salary, and this is allowance. Okay, so now what I can do is I can do a near each other. So what near each other does is, this is a radio button, just like search and result, this is available here. You can select near each other from here and it will look for all these four or five words, because I don't want to frame a query, you know, different judges might have framed it differently. I just want to use these four or five keywords to find my relevant judgment. So this is where all these five judgments, five words are coming in a range of 20 words. So I can always use my wildcard, say employ. I can say suspended can be suspension. So I can always say make it suspend. Make it salary and allowance are fine. So government employee, suspension, salary, allowance. I'll make my search selecting near each other. Okay, so now it will give me judgments where these four or five words are coming in a range of, so 20 words, so 26 such results. So government employee, salary, allowance during suspension. So very, very relevant, very, very exact results you'll be able to get by using near each other function here. So just write your keywords, select near each other. If there is a wild card you think you can use, you can always use that one. Okay, now this is the final query that I show from Manu Search, and I have a case study planned for you that we can both do. Okay, so this is given to me by a senior advocate. So it was, there was overwriting done on a check date. So this was a client has come to him that a suit was filed against him that he was involved in an overwriting of a check. So the question was that, can, was there any case where acquittal was given, because basically there was no evidence in this case. Okay, so I'll just write overwriting on check date. So part one of the process, just write your keywords. I selected overwrite. I can always say it can be overwritten. I just put a star after overwrite and I do a near each other. So near each other is just write your keywords, select near each other and make your search. Okay, so now it's giving me all the 22 results are there where overwriting date and check has been done. So all of them are coming together. Now I can just, since I'm looking for cases where acquittal was there, so I can just say acqui. And I can make my refine the search. So it will give me cases where it was acquittal was there, acquitted was there. These are four or five judgments that I can look up to. And this one has an SLP which was disposed. Okay. Let me go back. Okay. So this is one such case where overwriting on a check date was there. But what if I want, these are just 22 results. I want more results where these kind of cases can come. So I can always say ki overwriting can be, so here you have to put in your thinking cap. most of the times the search engine is very smart that it does the work for you, but sometimes you also have to pitch in a little bit. So just if I say for tempering can be one search word. Tempering on the check date can also be used. Okay. So I can just write temper and say check date, and I'll select. This is this formula, so not a very difficult thing. You just use inverted commas slash give the range. So this can by naturally it is 20. You can always write it 10. Okay. So this is a range. I want these three words in a range of 10 words. So this formula you can apply anywhere. So arbitration section 5, and you give a range of 6, 7. So automatically it will take where Arbitration and Conciliation Act section 7 is mentioned. This is a very advanced way to do a search. Now, all this I am telling you is available here in search tips. So anytime you open Manupatra, you will be able to use wildcards, you'll be able to do a unordered proximity search, ordered proximity search. So all this is available from here. And now from here, what I can do is I can select or. So I want this or this. These are the both, any of these two words I'm looking for. So now just check date. It was okay. Now I have increased my results to 20 to 40. So earlier there were just 22 results. Now we have 40 results with us. Now I can always search in result and say quit. So there are two problems that might occur, that you find very few judgments or that you find a lot of judgments. So both can be. If you want to increase the number of results, you can always use or and use synonyms of the words that you want to do. Synonym button is also available. Okay. This is there. How to use or. I have one query for you. So taking 2 minutes, you can read this one and we'll solve this one together. Okay, so you are approached by a lady, Miss Radha. Miss Radha has been working with an education institution for 2 years now. She took a maternity leave of 3 months. On returning, she found out that someone else has been hired in her place and she was no longer required. When she protested, she was given a reasoning that she is an ad hoc employee and not a regular employee. So we have to find case laws to help her. So from here, you have to find out what are your keywords mean and how will you begin this search. So maternity leave is something that pops out at you. You can just go to Manu search and start with and make your search. Okay, so these are all the 2000 some 3000 judgments where maternity leave is coming. Okay, now I can always refine this. That's our formula. Just take whatever is there, that's there in the judgment that you can do, and you can always refine it. Say I want to say termination from services. Either I can do this or I can say why not use near each other. So just select near each other from this termination. I can always say termination also can be like terminating or terminated from services. Service can also be used for. Okay, so I've written terminated service near each other and I'm refining this. Okay. Okay, so now we have 14,000 some results. Can always say the third one was the ad hoc. Say ad hoc in inverted commas. Okay, so I have 2,247 some judgments. Read the first one. This is my case. Petitioner allowed to continue in service. Okay. So this is one such query. What we have planned for tomorrow is we'll be taking a lot of these kind of queries. So the usual search patterns, what we see in Manupatra, and how to break those down, break searches down, that will be covered in tomorrow in a detailed lesson. So this was a query. Now let's take, if you have some questions on this, we can do that. Okay. Okay, so date. Okay, that slash basically means, I'll come to the slash. This slash basically means that this gives a range. So I'm writing three words. Tempering is there, check is there, and date is there. Okay. This slash basically denotes a range. So it gives a range of 10 words. So these three words in a slash or 10. So normally you don't even have to put it here. System automatically. So that's just a formula that you are using. So, you know, maternity leave, I can just say, and I select a near each other. So here I'm not making any kind of slash or anything. I'm just doing my search by selecting near each other. So automatically what the system is doing, I have not put anything here. Where maternity and leave is coming in a range of 20 words. This denotes range. So in a range of 20 words where maternity leave is there, it'll take all those judgments. Okay, please tell me about article search. Let's go to article search. So article search is possible, ma'am, through two ways in Manupatra. One is you just go to articles. From here, you will be able to select the subject and the sub-subject. Say, I want to say arbitration and I want to read like 2020. So here, from here, you can select the subject. You can select these are the various articles that comes to us from students, professionals, academic. So that way segregation is there. If you want to send us, you can also send us articles. So this is available here from table of contents. The second one is if you want to make a search from Manu. So this is right to be forgotten. So I was listening to this podcast where this was there. So right to be forgotten basically is like from here, if you find this article search, so this yellow button is there. So click on to this one. This will take you to all the right to be forgotten. So basically right to be forgotten is like you did something in your college years. We are living in a, you know, highly digitized world. So everything is being reported. So that particular thing that you did in college got picked up by some newspaper and it was in their website. So now you want that to be forgotten because anything that people types in your Google search and that things pops up at the number one. So this is right to privacy. Under that it's coming up. So here you will be able to see different journals that are outside Manupatra. So this is not in Manupatra, but we have taken articles that are outside Manupatra so that you can just read these. Okay, so this is your Google search, but a much more refined form of it, because we have just handpicked all these websites where best journals are available, best articles are available, and you don't have to go outside Manupatra to do this. Just go on Manu search and click to put your query here. And use this article, this radio button, and it will take you to the articles on the topic. Okay. Okay. So next one is our Boolean search, Boolean assisted search. So I was telling you that if you didn't understand, this particular session will be uploaded in our website. So you can always go back and, you know, you can refresh yourself. Also, there is this tips available, and assisted search is also there. So assisted search is basically Boolean made easy. So there's no slash, no inverted commas, nothing. So here, just put in your exact phrase. So it's just a form that you have to fill. Say dowry death, and make your search. Okay. So dowry debt in whichever judgment is coming as a phrase. So this is exactly as a phrase. Now there was that near each other thing in Manu search that can be replaced by these words. So these words is say dying declaration. Okay. And I can select the range. Say I want 5 words. So in whichever judgment, dowry, death, and dying declaration is there in the range of 5 words that you can choose from here. Also, I sometimes, you know, there is a like I'm doing my research on child custody, maintenance and everything, and it is picking maintenance from the company's law. So I don't want company's act right now. So I can always put a word that is coming in my research and I don't want it. So like this is something, so suppose there's, yes, I've spelled it correctly. So eyewitness, there's no eyewitness in this one. So I can just write none of these words and I can make my search. So now eyewitness is suddenly disappeared from my search. I can do here. Okay. This is also available from Manu search. So this is, we were able to do assisted search. Okay. The next one is how to make notes from this. So this is what you have done. This is your research. Now, how do I save? Is there a way to make notes on this, save this for later? So that kind of questions if you have. So there are 2-3 options available just to create real-time notes on Manupatra. The first one is you can just add it to a session list. So, you know, you're reading a judgment and you find this particular judgment. You can just keep adding these to the session list. And at the end of the, this will be up here, available here. Net these days is creating problems. Manu search around 12 regularly. This is happening. Disappoints. Okay, just let's go back to say Google. Go back. Okay, let's give it a second. Show you. Okay. If you have some questions, we can answer those. I hope you can hear me. Okay. Why we use Boolean search? So Boolean search is basically, sir, if you don't want to use, if you are looking for a specific word, say specific phrase, net. So there you need Boolean search. How can we send articles to you? Okay, you can send us articles by contacting us at contact@manupatra.com. So I'll show you that at the end of the meeting. So you can send us articles. Okay, we're back. So we will say from here, if you want to use dowry, death, make my search. Okay, so it will take all the dowry death judgments. I can add to the session list from here. Okay, so this is one way. So if I go to can net let's give it a second. Karnataka High Court judgment, Supreme Court. So again, from here also you will be able to see the number of times a particular judgment has been cited. So this has been cited 37 times. This particular judgment has been cited 27 times. Date of the judgment, title. So all available from here. Okay, this is Manu Instant. What Manu Instant does for you is it gives you a brief synopsis of the judgment. So from here you will be able to see the act of the judgment, the case note, the disposition. So a brief synopsis of the editorial enhancement that we have put in a particular judgment that you can see from here. Okay, just let's open any one of these. We can take questions in the meantime. Okay, how do you get to Manu Instant? Okay, ma'am, this is available in the from here. This feature, everything that I discussed, that is available in Manu Search. So this video will also be available on YouTube. So you can go back and refresh yourself. Okay, so this is one judgment. Open this one. So you're discussing how to save this. So there's this option available, save this document. So you can save it in cloud. So different folders are available. Click on this one and create a folder, say dowry. And you can put in a password also. So this is how you save. Never. And can go down dowry, save here. This will be saved. Now if I want to attend see this particular judgment, I can go back here and go to my save docs. This will be also available from here. Another one that you can do is you can create a note. So my notepad is there. So you can add to this notepad, say dowry, and you can copy something from the judgment or write something on your own. Whenever you open this, let's say submit, and like go down, submit this. Okay, so whenever next time anyone from my office or myself open this, so this I'll be able to see a note for myself. So this can be done from here, my notepad. Okay, another one that is there to how to keep real time notes. You know, you do a lot of work and you want to, you should know that you have done this and you want to keep it for yourself. Say I can select any one paragraph. So this is sticky note. Okay, just go up here, select sticky note. And you can select any one highlight, say this one I want to save. So you can color this particular line. So this is something that you found helpful. You can leave a comment here. Okay. Now also do, I can save this particular what I have highlighted in a folder. So I can either create a folder, or if I have already created a folder, I can just a very much relevant. Should read this judgment and save. Okay, so now once this is saved, there is this option available, sticky note summary, and you can select the topic. Say I'd created it in dowry death. So all the notes that I created that will be automatically available from here. So I can take out a printout of this. I can save this for later. So all the cases that I've gone through, all the important paragraphs that I've found, and a small note that. So these are the three things that we can do in terms of creating sticky notes in Manupatra and also saving it in Notepad, saving it in my folder. So this is how you can save a particular judgment to review later. Coming to the next feature, Boolean we have done. Real-time notes we have done. Okay, so how do you search a particular judgment with one section? So sometimes you just have a particular section in your mind. Okay, this is enough of Manu and assisted search. Let's go to legal search. Give it the credit it deserves. So here what is there is like all these section wise is also there. So you know, if you have a particular section in mind, usually people just put it in Manu search only, you know, CRPC section 28, and they find some result and they are more than happy with that. But you can, there's a specialized search in legal search for your particular section. Say I want to search for NI and 138. So just write here section 138. So all the judgments where NI 138 was there, you can see from here. This is can be relevance wise, decision date wise, which is the most cited on this one. You can always search and result from here. So if there's a 138 case, I can always search for the section first and do my query based search later. Cited most also you can do. Okay, what else we were doing? Can do so. Now I have selected this particular judgment. Now this is, if I don't want to read the entire judgment, I can always skim through the judgment like from here. So I need not read the entire judgment. This there was this question also from map. So for new instant, this is available. Beneath every judgment, there will be this sign. It shows which are the judgments, which are the acts, what is the prior history, what is the case note for that judgment. Okay, so this is our editorial team has put in this effort to show you a brief synopsis of the judgment before even opening the judgment. So you can always take out a printout from here if you don't want to read. So this is one way to skim through the judgment. The second way is if you open a judgment, okay, this is it's looking. Is this option of Manu important para? So what important para, we've discussed it yesterday also. I'll quickly go through it. It gives me the most quoted paragraph from a judgment. So this is Narayan and Menon versus State of Kerala. There is this paragraph in this judgment, 70 paragraph. It is the most key paragraph because this has been quoted 4 times in future judgments. So this is once a judgment where it's been quoted. Another judgment, people have directly copy pasted the judgment. So, you know, whenever you are quickly reading through a judgment, you need not read the entire judgment. You can just click on important para, and from there, you will get a list of paragraphs which were quoted in future judgments. Okay. So, again, if I find this particular paragraph relevant, I can always read the next paragraph, next judgment also. This judgment is also relevant to me. So, this is possible from here, M. So this is a very important. If you want to don't want to read the entire judgment, you can always come here and see the important paragraphs of the judgment first. This is one way to skim. Now let's go to the next one. Say on legal search only. If you want to say for NI 138. And I can always use another one, say CRPC 132. I can search on two different sections simultaneously. Okay, so these are the those admins where both these are available. Even the 73 is coming and 132 is also there. So all these admins will have both of these. So let me open one. To open any judgment, you can go from here, open document window. This will open this in new window. Let me quickly go through the template of the judgment. Yesterday also we have seen this. Tomorrow, today also, we'll take a quick look. So this is how a judgment looks in Manupatra. This is the citation. So click on to this one. This will give me the equivalent citation. So all the judgments where this was referred, you can see from here. Okay, so these are all the citations, cross citations for this particular judgment. Okay, this is the name of the judgment, decision date, judge bench, counsels that have been appearing. These are the subjects, banking, criminal. So these are all the acts that were used in this particular judgment. Now this is the relevant section. So it's actually based on Negotiable Instruments Act 138. Okay, so we have separated this. So out of all these, which is actually based on that section, this is referred. So these are the cases that were referred in this case. Everything is hyperlinked from here, you can see. And also this wheel is there in front of every judgment. So from here you can just see how many times a particular case was cited in the future subjects of law. Now this was discussed 50% of times, mentioned 46, and relied on 4% of time. So different treatment you will be able to see from here. Now this case has been cited 29 times, so much more citations, out of which this was discussed, mentioned. So just by reading the name of the judgment, we'll get a small idea of what is the treatment. So it has overruled one case, prior history, it is coming from a Bombay High Court decision. So everything is available to you in one format. You don't have to go and look what happened in Bombay. This is citing reference. So citing reference, out of all those cases which were cited, how many were mentioned, how many were discussed, and how many were affirmed. Okay, this is the case note of the judgment. This is the judgment. The judge's name is hyperlinked. Again, comprehensively hyperlinked. So anything that is mentioned, so if you want to read a particular act that is mentioned, if you read the commentary on the same, commentary is also available. Comprehensive hyperlinking is there for any case also. If you're reading this paragraph and this particular case comes up, always click on to this and it will take you to the judgment. So very helpful feature. For students, again, a very important feature is if you double click on any word, there is an option for no more. So no more gives you basically the dictionary meaning. So both the English and Hindi, net is a little slow, so is available from here. So double click on that word and no more option will pop up. So similarly, if a latent phrase pops up, you can select that and the no more option will be available. Suppose copy paste, if you want to do that, is also possible. That's control plus C and say control plus V. So there is no problem in copy pasting also from there. Judgment. Now from here, if I want to see the forward and backward references for a judgment. So forward is where the judgment was referred in the future judgment. Okay, so that can be dealt. So we were reading this judgment. This was referred in 241, 242 judgments. Now which are those judgments? So this is forward linking. So cited in para. Cited in para gives me list of all those judgments where it was cited. Also it gives me paragraphs. Okay, so this is a Delhi High Court judgment which is quoted Rupchand in 8 paragraph. If you want to read this, you can always read this also from here. Find this relevant, you can open this. So where this judgment was followed and which paragraph it was followed. This was in cited and para. Similarly, case map is there. So case map basically gives me 20 relevant judgments related to Rup Singh Rathore. So these are the, basically it can be considered as a timeline. So this is 2014. And these are the judgments that came before, prior to 2014. So these were cited in Rupchand and they were given different treatments. So this particular case, K. Bhaskaran, was overruled by Rup Singh. Now, another judgment was discussed by in Roop Singh. So this particular judgment was affirmed in Roop Singh. So all these features, so this is the backward linkage. So all the what happened to the previous cases. So sometimes you want to see the citing reference, like which case it affirmed, that you can find from it. Now what happened to Roop Singh in future? Okay, so it was relied on in this case, it was affirmed in this case, it was discussed in this case. So all these treatments are available. So in different judgments, like a 2018 Calcutta judgment, this was mentioned. And this was discussed in another judgment. So all the forward linkage is also there and the backward linkage is also there in one picture. Again, similar feature is authority timeline. So this was showing me for 20 cases. Now I want to see for all the 214 cases. So this gives me the entire list of judgments where this was cited. So this, now I can always break this down. So I just want to see the relied on cases where, which are positive to me. And this is affirmed, where this has been affirmed. So if it was dissented somewhere, this one case from Madhya Pradesh High Court, which has dissented with this case also. Okay. So all the citing references are available from here. Okay. The print replica is also available. So this is the Supreme Court copy for this judgment, Judice. So the court copy from the Judice website is available. So we provide it in every judgment. You can go here, print replica, and see there's one other journal. So this is Delhi Reported Judgment. So this is as it is, as it's coming in the Delhi Reported Judgments. It's available here. Another is the Judice copy. So sometimes publishers change the paragraph for a particular judgment. So we ensure that, you know, you should have a source document. So this is the source document which we have used for this template of Manupatra. If you want to take out a PDF printout for this, that also you can do. This is with or without case note. If you want to send someone a mail for this, that you can do. If you want to read a Word format of this, that you can do. Sticky note, we have already discussed. This is if you want to save it in Drive. So if you want to save it in Google Drive, that is also possible from here. This we have discussed. So you can always create folders in Manupatra. So you can save it here in your computer, in your office desktop. And when you go back to your home using your PC, you can view that same judgment logging on to Manupatra from here. Now coming to legal search, two act search is possible. Respondents way, very simple, just don't put anything, just write the party's name. So Vodafone was there. So I've just, in whichever the party name is Vodafone, I'll take all those judgments. Manu search searches in the entire judgment. If you put it in legal search, it will just search the title of the judgment. So Vodafone International Holdings Limited. Now, similarly, I can say Konkan Railway and Mehul Corporation. So I need not write verses or anything like that. Just use, just from here, you will be able to access the particular judgment. Now coming to the case note, if you just want to see in the case note, so they might not have written it in the judgment, but our editorial team might have put in gender justice in the case note. So you'll be able to search in the case note itself from here. Subject wise, so we have 50 subjects of law that are available. So we segregate different judgments on the basis of whether it's in direct tax judgment or arbitration judgment. So if you want to keep yourself updated, say I'm an insolvency lawyer, I just want to see what are the new things coming up on insolvency. Just can make a search on this. So I can select by newest, whichever be the newest decisions on insolvency that I'll be able to access. These are the most cited decisions. Around this time, the net, it's a little problem. Okay, let's go to legal search. If you have any questions, we can do that. Subject wise also is there. Relevant section. So relevant section is also there. So I was telling you in that judgment, whichever if a judgment is based on a particular relevant section, that also we provide. So there is a search that is separate for that. So if you're looking for IPC 300 judgment only, this is the exact thing you want. So that you can always search from relevant section search. Make a search. That is again. Okay, so these are 2007 judgments that are based on IPC 302. This is the most cited one of 1973. Again, going back to legal search, let's go to the Act search now. So this is basically citations are also available. So if there are any questions on this, we can take that. Then we'll take the Indian citations. Anshul said this will be uploaded within 6 hours, 5 to 6 hours. This will be available on YouTube. So the meaning of cited in para is where this has been cited exactly. Langesh sir, this is exactly what I mean, where this particular judgment was cited in other judgments, and it also gives you the paragraph. Cited in para, Manu Patra is also giving you where this was cited. Okay, let's come back to the search. This is citation. So we cover more than 325 journals with us. So SEC, AIR, DLT, all these journals from volume 1 till today will be accessible to you. Say, I want to say AIR only. World Supreme Court. So there's no need, just put in the years, say 1997. And you can, since there's no volume number in AIR, no need to put that. You can put the volume number as 301, page number. And from here, you will be able to access that citation. There are many softwares that are just based on citation search only, so they are just using the journal. We offer a lot more than that. Okay, so this is citation search. Now, just one more, Act search is there. So Act search, we had discussed earlier also from the Bayer Act, we can see. Now, if I want to see the particular act, so Income Tax Act, Sumit sir's query was also there. So this is Income Tax Act 1961. If you want to see the selected act, you can always see. So this is, here it's written 1961, but it is amended as per today. So any new notification or anything new that has been coming. So this is inserted by Finance Act 2019-2020. So this is also available. So this is as per today. This is the parent act that came in 1961, but this is amended as per today, not the old act. This is the newest act with all the amendments that have been coming. Say we are looking for something else, say CRPC, Code of Civil Procedure. I can select the particular. If I want to look for a particular word also, I can do that. Say review. In CRPC, a review comes in one section. This is 362. Review is there, and if you want to read the commentary on this particular section, you can always click onto this one and read the commentary. So both the act and the commentary are available. If you want to read the judgments from here, you can always go there. Okay, so this is how you search a particular act. Go to legal search, go to act search, type in your three words, and you can do the selected act. So from here, the entire act is present in front of you. You can take out a printout from here. You can do a copy paste. It's no problem like that. Okay. This is about it. So if there is any more questions, I can take that. This particular session will be available on our website and on YouTube. And we'll have another session tomorrow just for case studies. Sir, we have the Nidhi ma'am, we have the case summaries. So sometimes there is no law point in the particular judgment. So that way we don't have the case note. But in most of the Supreme Court judgments, all the High Court judgments even, you'll have the case note. Sir, Anand sir, you can just write to us at contact@manupatra. I'll share our email ID and you will be able to do something for you, sir. Legal analytics allow all the citations. So what is legal analytics? Basically, citation analysis, you can see all the judgments. So SE, TextMan, all the judgments can be, all the citations can be accessed from there. To find this, Sirivan, sir, we covered the amendment in the previous session. So yesterday's session, we had covered where to see new amendments. That is available in the Bare Act section. So this is can be accessed from here. You can see our YouTube video from yesterday and you will be able to access. Sir, M judgment, M is available only in judgments, in Supreme Court judgments, where it has a paragraph which was quoted in future judgments. If it doesn't have any paragraph which was quoted, so you won't find M there. So the mark cases can be found in the Bare Act section also. This also we covered yesterday. So you can go to our YouTube channel and you will be able to access. Notifications on the basis of sections. Okay. So that can be accessed if there is an amendment made based on the notification that will be there on the Bare Act itself. Say, I'll show you for one. I remember one. Say, Electricity Act. And if I'm looking for section one, so if there was an amendment, so there was an amendment in amendment made on section one through this notification. So that can be accessed from here. So this will be there on the Bare Act. Come back to the questions. So this will be on our, Nisha ma'am, this will be on our YouTube's channel. So I'll just show you how to access that. Go to YouTube. Anupatra. And from here, this channel is there, which has 108 subscribers. Click on Manupatra there. And all the sessions that we have been doing, that is available here. Okay. Thank you, Anand sir. Thank you so much, sir. Always a pleasure. Okay. So this is about it for me today. If you have any questions, if you have any suggestions regarding software or anything, and how we can do this better. We, in the pre-COVID days, we used to organize these sessions in your colleges also. So you can always write to us at contact@manupatra. If we need an offline session or an online session also, we are conducting these days. So please send us a feedback at contact@manupatra. Any article that you need to submit, any problem that you have with Manupatra, we'll give you a prompt response. Thank you for giving me your time. Thank you.